Welcome to our Powerproject tutorials. For more resources, including a downloadable manual, select the link below.
Let's go to page 23, and we're going to start organizing our schedule. I think the most important thing in building a good schedule is having a good organizational structure. So if you've got your schedule open, I'm going to show you how to build an organizational structure. To do this, I'm going to break my project down into four main categories. In order to build that outline, I'm going to right-click on project and insert a child summary. And window pops up, insert before which bar line. I'm going to say just at the end of the chart. And I'm going to call this milestones. And I usually just use the bar title, leave the task title blank, and it'll default to the bar title. You can get a little sophisticated in your naming. I'm going to add another one for design. I'm going to add a new child summary, go to the end of the chart, I'm going to call it design. I'm going to add one more for, I'm going to add another one for procurement. And I'm going to add one more down there for construction. Once again, at the end of the chart. And I've got my four basic settings for my chart. Now I've got over here, if I right click on my project tab, my project link over here on the left, and I go to appearance, this is showing you what my, where my heading colors are coming from. My black is from the very top part of my outline. This green is the next part of my outline. I'm going to have my next level is going to be blue. I'll go ahead and add one while I'm here and make it light yellow. I'll have another outline color to go through, and you'll see that pop up. I'm going to go into my construction, and I'm going to insert a child in construction. I'm going to add four in here as well. One is going to be my general conditions. I'm going to add another one in construction. Notice when I add, it's letting me select where I want to put it. One general conditions, I'm going to have site work. I'm going to have a building, selecting it at the end of the chart. And I'm going to do one more for site finishes. And this is the typical way that I go through building my outline for my project so that I can create my schedule and have it well organized. So let's take our building. By the way, this outline structure that I'm creating is on page 24 in your book. So I'm going to go into building. I'm going to add a new one for substructure. Add another one for structure. I'll do one for exteriors. And then one for interiors. Notice that when I select one of these headings, that my area over here for activities are empty. All of these areas are empty. I haven't added any activities yet. In the manual, you'll notice when we get to page 25 and 26, it starts talking about summary task. Basically, in creating that outline structure, that's what you have just created, is a group of summary tasks that right now are empty because there are no activities on it. But if I select building, for example, you can see my structure, exteriors, and interiors, and you can see there's summary tasks over here that are basically empty at this point.
Thanks for watching our tutorial. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe to our channel. Please leave comments.